So it's finally happened. You've had enough of dealing with messy spreadsheets and data silos that are scattered all around your company, and you've decided to use a product information management system instead. Good call, we're happy to have you on board. But now that you're joining Team PIM, you have another decision that you need to make. What kind of PIM to go for? By now, you might have seen the terms open source and SaaS, or software as a service, floating around. But what do these actually mean? And what about building a PIM in-house? Is that a practical option for your company? Or will you be biting off more than you can chew? I get it. There's a lot to consider, which is why I'm here to help guide you through your PIM selection process. I'm Manuela with Politics, and in this video, we're going to look at what the terms custom built, open source, and SaaS mean, specifically in the context of PIM software. If you want a more in-depth explanation of these terms for software in general, we do have a video on that too, which you can find on our channel. But because software in general is a really big umbrella, and you can't really compare software meant to stream music to something like a PIM system, in this video, we're going to focus on how open source, SaaS, and custom built PIM software differ from each other, and of course, the pros and cons of each, so that you can decide which one is best for you and your business. I'm going to look at these from the most to the least complicated in terms of implementation. So let's start with custom built PIMs before moving on to open source and then finally SaaS. Custom built systems are the ones that companies build themselves or pay specialists to build for them that are 100% coded according to the company's exact specifications, from start to finish. Logically enough, this means that it's significantly more work throughout your PIM journey right from the beginning. In terms of timing, it can take up to 6 times as long to get a custom built PIM in working order compared to adapting an open source option. And let's not even get into how much faster going with SaaS would be. At least not yet anyway, more on that story later. Of course, as we all know, in the world of business, time means money. And the time factor here means that it's also a pretty massive financial investment, considering that the people spending months or even years putting this tech together and then maintaining it are gonna wanna be paid for their time. I mean, it's not an unreasonable request on their part, but still it is something that you need to bear in mind. The big advantage here though is that because you're building everything yourself, you can customize every tiny detail however you like. So if your company has highly specific needs when it comes to how your products are organized, the type of information you need to store, permission levels, integrations, and so on, then this may well be the option for you. Just bear in mind that these customizations will of course take time and effort on the part of whoever's making them, which again means more expense on your part. And unfortunately, much as my mother liked to tell me as a child, money does not in fact grow on trees. Another plus though, building something yourself means that your team will probably end up being intimately familiar with every aspect of the system, or we can hope, which may prove helpful for future updates and troubleshooting, because this level of familiarity is pretty important if you consider that unless someone's been selling it on the side, no one else is using your software. So outside of whoever's built it, there's also no one to turn to who'll immediately be familiar with your system and be able to quickly fix it if anything ever goes wrong. On the other hand, if you use your own in-house team, at least you're not dependent on any other vendors or companies. The source code is yours to use as you wish, forever. And you have absolute control over how it develops. The situation could be a little different if you commission an external company to build one of these systems for you, but whatever happens, you should end up owning the code that's produced on your behalf. Right, so we've established that using a custom-built PIM gives you a great amount of power, but to quote the also great Stan Lee, with great power comes great responsibility. And if you're using a custom built PIM, you're responsible for everything related to said PIM, including maintenance, hosting, compliance with security regulations, keeping it up to date, and dealing with any problems that can arise. If you try and implement a new update and a bug in your code ends up disrupting your Shopify integration, preventing your product information from getting distributed, that's on you. If Google changes its requirements for its CSV feeds, it's up to you to adapt your PIM accordingly. If hackers find their way into your system, it's your job to kick them out and try to stop them from coming back. Basically, you name it, it's your job, which is why custom-built PIMs tend to be most popular with enterprise-level companies, since they're the ones that have the resources available to maintain this kind of software, and they're the ones that are most likely to have the highly particular needs that make this level of customization even necessary in the first place. So let's do a quick recap of the pros and cons of custom builds. Looking at the pro column, we've got infinite customization, inside knowledge of how everything works, and independence from other companies and or intellectual property rights. As for the con column, we've got time to get started, money to get started, time and money spent on keeping it running, lack of outside help, and responsibility for, well, everything. Up next, open source PIM systems. For these PIM systems, anyone can download the basic code framework, generally for free, and then customize it according to the needs of their company. For a lot of people, this is a pretty intriguing option. I mean, who wouldn't be intrigued by getting something for free, right? It sounds great on the surface, but is it too good to be true? I guess the real question here is open source PIM really free? Short answer, yes and no. Helpful, I know, but that's the way it is. Yes, open source code is normally free to download and use, up to a point, but no, that's not to say that there are no costs involved. And I'll explain why in just a minute, but before that, let's talk about the positives. Just like with a custom build program, using an open source PIM gives you complete control over the software once you've downloaded and adapted it, which is fantastic if you know what you're doing, or if you can pay somebody who does. The difference between open source and custom built PIMs though, is that while with a custom built system, you literally build everything from scratch, with an open source PIM, you're starting from that free framework that somebody else has built, and you are then fitting it to your use case. So it is faster to get started with an open source system than a custom one, like we said. Don't get me wrong though, it's still not as fast as getting started with SaaS, but if you've got highly particular requirements when it comes to your data, but you don't want to go with the full custom built route, then yes, open source may be the best option for you. Another cool thing about open source PIMs, community support. Sites like GitHub are full of previous versions of open source software that people have worked on, stuff that's being coded at the moment to fix issues people are having, and information and discussion about how to best use the software itself. Of course, you're gonna want to check the quality of anything that you use from a community source. Think of it like using Wikipedia for information. You're gonna want to double check the details before using it for anything important, but still, it's a great place to start. Also, what someone's developed to work with their particular ERP or other system might not necessarily work with yours. Still, if you vet your code well, this can be a fantastic source of free help. One more point for open source. Like with custom builds, you get a certain level of independence, depending on who you get to do your coding. If you download an open source framework and then get your own team, whether it's in-house or outsourced, to develop it, then you've got absolute control over your version. But if you prefer, you also have the option of going back to the company that originally made the source code and employing their services for either customization or maintenance. Fun fact, that's actually how a lot of open source software companies get their primary revenue. Right, so now the less positive side of open source software. While there are plenty of open source programs out there for other simpler purposes that you can just download and start using, due to its technical nature, PIM is a bit more complicated. An open source PIM will provide you with a basic framework, but it's gonna take time and therefore money to get it into working order. If your company is involved in software development in addition to e-commerce, then hey, maybe you already have access to a team that can do this themselves without the need for outside help. But if not, you'll need to either go to whoever made the PIM originally to get them to do the setup for you, or you can hire a third party. And all of these options have a cost attached. This will be the case for any customization you need at the start or down the line, as well as for updating your systems when necessary. On top of that, we can't forget that, again, you, your team, or whoever you're paying to code for you will also have to take responsibility for security,
maintenance, compliance, data regulations, hosting arrangements, training, troubleshooting, and
any other trials and tribulations that life throws your way. It's your code, so it's your job. Be extra careful with security in particular, because if everyone can see the original source code your system is based on, then it's possible that that could also benefit people trying to hack their way in. After all, it's a lot easier to rob a bank if you've got access to its original blueprint, or so I've heard and seen. Casa de Papel, anyone? Or money heist for my English speaking friends? All right, let's recap the open source pros and cons. And again, it's a pretty similar situation to custom builds. The pros: increased customization, independence from other companies and or intellectual property rights, and online community support. In the con column, we have time and money to get started, time and money to keep it going, possible additional security risks, and responsibility for, again, everything. Okay then, let's have a look behind door number three and enter the world of SaaS. If you recall, SaaS, or software as a service, is when you pay for a subscription that lets you use a PIM produced by another company for as long as you continue paying to do so. Or if you're really lucky, you might find one of the few PIM software companies which offer a free version. The biggest benefit of using a SaaS PIM solution is you don't have to code anything yourself, which, yes, means you have less control, but you also have a lot less work. It's the responsibility of the company providing your PIM solution to stay up to date with industry standards, to be vigilant against new security risks, to adapt to new channels and technologies that appear. All of that workload is on their shoulders and those of their dedicated team of developers, which in turn frees up your time and resources. It's really a pretty decent deal if you consider that you'll also get access to all of their previous experience and know-how and avoid the potential risk of coding something yourself that turns out to be unsuitable, unusable, or unsafe in terms of data security. You'll also be able to get up and running a lot faster than with open source or custom built options, since in this case, the software is already being utilized by other users, meaning that the company already knows what they're doing and they can guide you through the implementation process quickly and easily. So if you want to get your data organized and streamline your selling as fast as possible, then SaaS may well be your best bet. That way, getting set up could take you a matter of weeks, as opposed to who knows how long if you choose to build a system from scratch yourself. Of course, the biggest drawback here is the lack of control over the source code compared to open source or building your own system. While a quality SaaS PIM option should provide all of the customization and functionality you require, since like we said, they've got the experience to know what most users need, if there's anything super specific that you want to change about a SaaS PIM, you'll have to ask the company providing it to do it for you, and it's up to them whether they take your request on board or not. On that note, it's a really good idea to check out software review sites like Captera or G2 to see what other people have said about their customer service and level of responsiveness to customer requests. Either way though, at least with SaaS, you know that any coding required will be done by PIM experts, whether it's in response to a customer request, keeping the system up to date with other platforms' developments, or simply one of the many regular upgrades that SaaS PIMs carry out. Another factor to investigate beforehand, the details of the contract duration. If you're nervous about commitment, as so many of us are, then be careful not to get tied into a long-term contract before you're sure that you're choosing the right company. Ideally, you want a rolling contract while you're still trying out a PIM. That way, you know that you're just going to pay for it as long as you need to. Better yet, a lot of subscription-based PIMs also offer a free trial, which is a handy way to check out the software's functionality and ease of use before committing. Okay, time for one last set of pros and cons. The pros of SaaS are: it's quick to get started, there's a lower implementation cost, way less responsibility and hassle, and you get the benefits of your PIM provider's experience. As for the cons, there's less customization and possibly having to commit to one company. Ultimately, the decision comes down to the degree of customization that you require. Think of PIM as a warehouse and your data as stock. If you're selling something that's incredibly complicated, sure, it might make sense to have a super specialized warehouse built from scratch to guarantee that it'll be suitable for storing your things. Maybe you're trading in exotic animals who only consume dry ice, but also need to sleep near an open flame. Sure, in that case, custom building a warehouse may be the best, if not your only option. But if your storage needs aren't quite that complex, You need to think about whether it's really worth the expense and the hassle to build a bespoke warehouse just for storing your things. Depending on how complicated your needs are, you'll find that it makes a lot more sense to either take a pre-existing basic framework and build it up according to your needs, or easier still, rent a space from someone whose structure and ideas are aligned with yours and who you know will take your feedback in consideration when possible. So there you have it, the key differences between open source, custom built, and SaaS PIMs. I hope you found this helpful and now feel a little more ready to make a decision about what type of PIM is right for you and your business. For more information about PIM systems and a bunch of other e-commerce topics, check out the other videos on our channel. And if you like what you see, make sure you hit subscribe and hit that bell button. Thanks for watching and see you next time.